हाय फ्रेंड्स, तो नेट के फॉर्म्स निकल गए हैं। क्या आपने अफ्रीकन लिटरेचर का भी पढ़ना स्टार्ट किया कि नहीं? इफ़ यू हैवन्ट स्टार्टेड रीडिंग अबाउट अफ्रीकन लिटरेचर, आई मस्ट टेल यू यू शुड नाउ, बिकॉज देर आर हार्डली 2 months लेफ्ट। सो आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक दैट यू शुड नॉट मिस इन अफ्रीकन लिटरेचर, दैट इज़ अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट ऑथर एफ्रा बेन एंड हर मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट वर्क ओरिनोको। So guys, you must be thinking now that why I called her African writer. Actually, she is not an African writer, but she is a British writer. I called her African writer because this work of on African literature or African people made her so popular that many people think that she is a African writer. Basically, this is on slavery and how slavery affected the normal people. Moreover, the protagonist Orinoco is a royal king. She has tried to portray him as a European. His features and everything, she has, you know, made him as a person from a European caste, because she wanted to connect with English society, because this novel was written for the English society. But she wanted to tell like how a person who is black in color get hurts if you treat him like a animal. Yes, my friends, everybody gets hurt. We should not go on skin color. He was a king and he was very talented. He had fought so many wars. So my point here is that he killed, if you have read the novel, he killed his own family in the end of the novel, which is very tragic. Just give a thought on this. A person killing his own family members just because he doesn't want any insult on their caste. So, this was the main theme which I just said. Here, I would like to add a reference from Elizabethan very famous play Othello, written by Shakespeare. So, have you ever thought, my friends, that this play was also on a very important theme which I just discussed in the first half of the video? The most important theme again here comes racism. In the play Othello, the protagonist has been again and again called as Moor. So this is also a very derogatory term, you know, this is not a good term to mention somebody. So here also Elizabethan times, in that time also, he is trying to portray that how a person like Othello, who was also a king, same as Orinoco, he was also a king, Othello was also a king, still he got betrayed by Iago, right? But how he was able to just make him feel that his own beloved is fooling on him. So why? Have you ever thought why? Because he was not confident about himself. That's why he got fooled so easily. He was not able to have that much confidence in him that a girl can betray him. If a person is confident, he is always, you know, so much in confidence that this girl will never fool me. But he considered himself as in low self-esteem. That's why he got fooled. So there are many other novels, you know, like Heart of Darkness by Joseph Conrad. All these novels show how slavery has affected the people who are in black in color. So we should stop all the racism. You know, reading novels is not just a part of life. We should inculcate all these things in our own personal life as well. The main aim of literature is not just to read novels. It is to, you know, get into everything and understand why we are reading this. I would like to conclude my video here by saying that all individuals are equal. They are made equal by God, so we need to treat them equally. Don't treat anybody as animals, and moreover, animals should be treated as humans. So, you know, the point is treat everybody equally and with kindness. So, here I end my video, guys. I hope you enjoyed. And if you did, please give us a big like on Literary Reviews and subscribe our channel. Hit that red button there and also hit that bell, ting, ting, ting next to it, so that you get notified every time we post a video. All right then. Bye-bye. Take care. See you in my next video.